A double blow today for the state's embattled economy. The air warfare destroyer project delayed again, and the biggest rise in unemployment in the country. Political reporter Adam Todd joins us live in the newsroom with the details. Adam?
Beck, we'll start with the jobs numbers. There's 9,000 fewer people in work here in SA than there was just a month ago. The unemployment rate hitting 5.7% compared with 5.4% in July. And we've bucked the trend around the country, the national unemployment rate falling to 5.1% compared with 5.2% just a month ago. And on the back of that news, comes the news that one of the state's key projects, the air warfare destroyers, is facing yet another delay. The band plays on, but all is not well for the air warfare destroyers. The finish date pushed out again, just don't call it a delay.
A re-baselining of the project.
Today marked the traditional keel-laying ceremony for the first warship, which will now be delayed by 3 months. The third and final destroyer won't be finished until 2019, rather than 2018. The Defence Minister says the industry wants to avoid a gap between the completion of the warships and the commencement of the future submarines project in 2020.
They were very concerned about what they described as a valley of death, which was the completion of a lump of work and then a gap before new work came on stream.
But that valley of death was dug by the government itself when it delayed the future submarine project by 4 years. The delay won't mean fewer jobs, but it will mean many will come later.
We will hire some people on a slower profile later, but the workforce has still got to grow by about 200 people on this site.
But many believe the true reason for the delay is budgetary, the move deferring $100 million in expenditure.
Given that we're going through a very difficult budget time of fiscal constraint, that the movement out of the forward estimate years of about $100 million does help us.
But in some good news, the Future Submarine Systems Centre will be based in Adelaide.
This will create hundreds of jobs, high-level jobs.
Now, in fact, that centre will create 800 jobs, but when you consider the state lost 9,000 in the last month alone, it gives you some idea of the scale of the problem facing the government. Now, mining and defence have been two key pillars of the state's economy, and yet in the past fortnight alone, we've had the delay on the Olympic Dam expansion and now a delay for the air warfare destroyers. The state sure could do with some good news on the economy.